to the hospital. They need a lot of wood at the hospital, Billy.
And I'll go up and see Jimmy while I'm there. Just wait till I tell the folks. Just wait till I tell them. Bye!
We'll return to a special feature of the morning movie, The Mid-Morning Report, with me, Merri Dee, immediately following these announcements.
We finally found it. We've scoured the market from coast to coast, and here it is, the carpeting of the 80s. Rich, plush, beautiful, wearable, and yours at a price reminiscent of the 50s. Where can you buy it? At Lincoln, your largest shop at home service. How can you buy it? By calling Lincoln now. We'll bring large samples to your home, no obligation. So lovely you want to touch it. Gorgeous, multicolored, deep shag in a fabulous choice of 11 rich, vibrant color blends. Still only $169 for 3 rooms full, 34 square yards, excluding padding and installation. Still less than $10 a month. It looks fabulous, wears beautifully, and costs only $169 for 3 rooms full. And Lincoln has thousands of rolls ready for immediate installation. Free bonus, 6 place settings, 24 pieces of tableware by International Silver. Call Lincoln now at National 2-9000. Call now, National 2-9000.
People, Places, and Things, an informal notice of community affairs in the Chicagoland area. The Omni House in Wheeling wants to help you develop the ability to solve your own difficulties, to be a stronger individual. For more information, call 541-0190. A youth lounge is open for member teens at Meyer Kaplan in Skokie every Wednesday evening, and each member can bring 2 guests. For details, call 675-2200. The Faith Youth Group is sponsoring a spook house at 1118 Westchester in Westchester, Illinois, on Friday afternoon. For more information, call 343-1030. And if you have any notices, projects, or activities in your community you'd like people to know about, send the information 3 weeks in advance to People, Places, and Things, WGN Television, 2501 Bradley Place, Chicago, Illinois, 60618. The advocates for the handicapped encourage disabled voters to vote, please, on November 4th. Call your county clerk's office for an absentee ballot application.
Homemakers wants responsible young adults to know that you can rely on us. We'll help you furnish your home with a payment plan suited to your budget. And even if you don't have a credit history, we'll make a special effort to help you get the credit you deserve. After all, it's hardly a home without furniture. And for young people starting out, Homemakers is the perfect place to find the furnishings and the credit for your special needs. Woodville, Donner's Grove, and Orland Square.
Good morning. This is the Mid-Morning Report. Tonight's presidential candidates' debate say they may do more than just give Ronald Reagan and Jimmy Carter a chance to attack one another. In what political analysts call a very close race, the debate may swing undecided voters to vote to one side and cause voters who have made up their minds possibly to switch. Ronald Reagan flies to Cleveland this afternoon for that debate. President Carter is already there. The debate begins at 8:30 this evening and will be nationally televised. Sources in Tehran say parliamentary debate on the fate of the American hostages will probably continue for several more days or possibly longer. The legislators are not meeting today because it is a Muslim holiday, but they will convene again tomorrow. Saudi Arabia has broken diplomatic relations with Libya because of Libya's disapproval of American AWACR radar planes in the Desert Kingdom. Libyan leader Gaddafi calls the plane's presence tantamount to American intervention. The state-run Amman Radio says King Hussein of Jordan has placed his army under the command of Iraqi leadership. The radio reports stress that Hussein has become a staunch supporter of the Iraqis in the Persian Gulf War that is now in their 6th week. In Iran, the Ayatollah Khomeini says peace with Iraq is not acceptable because of the crimes he says Iraq has committed during the Persian Gulf War. Khomeini's remarks were broadcast on Tehran radio. Meanwhile, Iraq reports a new tank assault on the northern and eastern approaches to Abadan. Fierce fighting is also reported at the port city of Karamshar, that's 9 miles northwest of Abadan. Authorities say a drug runner, one of 23 people charged in connection with a multi-million dollar Chicago heroin ring exposed last week, remains at large today. Also sought are more than 100 luxury and race car police say that were purchased with profits from those drug sales. A new Jill Clayburgh movie has opened in town, and again she plays a today's woman. Now it's Roy Leonard's turn to review it.
It's difficult to like a movie when you just can't relate to the main character, but I sort of enjoyed It's My Turn, so let's give credit to filmmaker Claudia Weill. She's made a very interesting movie about the problems of the contemporary woman. Jill Clayburgh plays a girl who has everything, except a good backhand for ping pong. She has her doctorate in math and a successful teaching job. She lives with a divorced, also successful businessman, and they have a terrific live-in relationship. But then she meets a baseball player, played by Michael Douglas, and suddenly she realizes that not everything is quite as right as she would like it. Her current lover is far from serious. Whenever the conversation gets a little weighty, he cracks jokes. Well, Douglas is the opposite. He's concerned that his baseball playing days are over, and the fact that she doesn't know anything about the game or how popular he once was brings a welcome freshness to their romance. There's a nostalgic sequence filmed at Yankee Stadium during an old-timers game that'll please the baseball fans. Now, this scene early in the movie is right after the two have met, and Clayburgh discovers there are some things she just can't do.
All right, I'll give you the pitch, and you gotta hit it with the bat.
Okay.
All right? Okay. Here comes the first one. Outfield's moving in.
Okay.
Pitch is coming. Yes, she's got it. It's a big one. Lewin's moving left. He's back. He's got it. She's going in for two. He took it. That was close.
Out is not close.
You notice the synchronization. They're going very well here, all right? I'm giving you a curveball this time. Lewin's outfield's moving in and over. She's ready. The pitch is coming.
Oh, no! Left! No! Lewin
hits it. It's out of the left field. She's going. Lewin's back. Rounding second. Heading for third. She's going for third. She's going for third. She's out.
This is a dumb game.
Jill Clayburgh, as a modern woman who finds out that old-fashioned values do have their place in the contemporary world. The movie is called It's My Turn. It's rated R because of language and some pretty explicit lovemaking, but it's an interesting movie for adults. I'm Roy Leonard for WGN News.
In pro football last evening, Miami scored two touchdowns in the final minutes and a half, but the Dolphins still lost to the New York Jets. That score was 17-14. In pro basketball, the Bulls host Milwaukee tonight at the stadium. And in hockey, the Blackhawks will be playing at Detroit. And as expected, Ralph Houk is the new manager of the Boston Red Sox. The Houston Astros have fired club president and general manager Tal Smith, one of the few executives ever to get the axe after the team he put together reached the playoffs. Former Yankee president Al Rosen will be replacing Smith. Our weather forecast for the Chicagoland area is cloudiness and cold today. Occasional snow flurries also, mainly along the lakeshore, high in the upper 40s. Fair and cold again this evening, low in the low 30s, rather chilly. Very near the lake, it's mid-20s in the outlying areas. And tomorrow, partly cloudy, continued cold, high in the mid-40s. Right now it is officially 36 degrees at O'Hare Field in Midway, 38 degrees right along the lakefront. Relative humidity is 67%, and the wind is from the north at 16 miles per hour. That's our news, sports, and weather. Please join us again this afternoon at 1:08 for our next newscast. In the meantime, have a nice, nice day.
Original flax soap cleans wood safely.
New liquid flax soap cleans wood safely, and it pours.
For years, I fought the battle of the bulge. Finally, I said, hey, Jack, get serious. And that's when I discovered Diet Delight and started using it as part of a regular plan of exercise and watching my calories. In fact, there are up to 40% fewer calories in Diet Delight than regular canned fruit, and not a speck of processed sugar. And Diet Delight isn't loaded down with heavy syrup, so it tastes like fruit, pure and simple.
When you get serious, get Diet Delight.
Deborah and Jenny had a perfect partnership. A successful unmarried photographer and her 11-year-old daughter. Then the Wolfman came along.
How about you had a surprise last night with Mom? What do you mean?
She snores.
But these days, relationships aren't so simple for grown-ups.
There's you. There's me. Separately, we're terrific. Together, we're a mess.
Mom's not happy. I'm not happy, and Theo's not happy.
It's not a happy situation.
Patty Ducastin, David Burney, Keenan Wynn, Danielle Brisbois, Vivica Linfers, John Lithgow, and Chris Barnes in Time Life Television's delightful, compelling production of a very special love triangle. Mom, the Wolfman, and Me, adapted from the best-selling novel by Norma Klein, a presentation of Operation Prime Time.
Tonight at 7 o'clock here on TV 9.
For the first time ever, China has sent an official exhibition to the United States. There are hundreds of exciting things to see and do. Chinese master chefs preparing delicious treats, skilled craftsmen demonstrating their traditional arts, rare antiquities, and beautiful gifts to buy. Don't miss this exciting Chinese festival.
The China Trade and Cultural Exhibition is here now through November 9th. Tickets are selling fast. You can buy yours at Navy Pier, Carson Perry Scott, and Ticketron. This is WGN Television Chicago, 1 minute before 10 a.m. It's now time to return to our morning movie, Mrs. Wiggs of the Cabbage Patch.
Just like one of them fairy stories where the fellow rubs the lamp and the thieves jumps out of the jars and brings him the magic carpet that flies. So as he can go high-kiting through the air like a witch on a broomstick and drop down any place he pleases.